Fox News is making it clear that they are absolutely obsessed with newly elected Democratic representative-to-be Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. They have run nonstop segments about how she can't afford a place in Washington, D.C. yet because she hasn't been paid yet. She wasn't making a lot of money in her previous job. She doesn't have a ton saved up. So they actually mocked her not that long ago because she can't afford a place to live. Haha, look at the stupid poor person, right, Fox? They then actually went after her for wearing an expensive outfit for a photo shoot, but not being able to afford rent. Those are things that actually happen. I've had to do photos before, and sometimes you have to rent outfits. Sometimes people chip in to help you buy them, or sometimes the place doing the photography actually lends them to you. None of this has any impact on Ocasio-Cortez whatsoever, so Fox News tried a different route. They decided to lump her and several other newly elected Democratic women to the House of Representatives. They created a graphic the other day where they were exposing the new radical left and their horrifying agenda for America. And here's that agenda that they threw up on screen with the pictures of these four women. It was free college for all, free health care for all, abolish ICE, and a Green New Deal. Could you imagine the horrors of living in a country that actually took climate change seriously? A country that actually allowed our children, our students, to go to college for free, that gave us health care, that didn't have this immigrations and customs enforcement agency and put Border Patrol back in the hands of the people who had it before ICE was formed just 13 short years ago? Yeah, things would have been just fine without ICE. They were running fine before they existed. They will run fine if we abolish them. It's not going to open the borders and allow a flood of migrants to come through. But here's the thing. Fox News is pushing this and trying to wrap it around the heads of these newly elected Democratic women because they're afraid of these women. They are deathly afraid of Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. But she doesn't miss a beat, right? She retweeted their little image and said, "Oh no, they discovered our vast conspiracy to take care of children and save the planet." And she's 100% right with that. That's the so-called liberal conspiracy that these women are out there pushing, is to take care of each other and save the planet. How is that bad? How does that make this country worse? How is that something we should be afraid of? Fox News didn't quite get into that because they have no answer for any of those questions. But here's the thing. They're afraid of it because if Democrats come along and enact these policies, or at the very least get Republicans to vote against these policies, then that's ballgame. The majority of people in this country support those ideals, with the exception of abolishing ICE, but the other ones in there, acting on climate change, universal health care, debt-free college, you got majorities out there in this country, left, right, and center, who support those. And if these young women coming into Congress are the ones who can do it, they're showing us that not only are they reshaping the Democratic Party in the best way possible, but that they're very serious leaders and they're people who are going to go on to rule this country one day. And that is exactly what needs to happen. And Fox News is afraid of that, because they know that these young women are not going to come in and cut taxes for corporations. They're not going to cut taxes for News Corp or Rupert Murdoch or any of the other executives at Fox News. Instead, they're going to make them pay their fair share so that people in this country can have health care, can have access to better education, so that we can stop giving fossil fuel companies everything they want and instead start taking care of the planet. That's the vast conspiracy that Fox News is trying to hang around the heads of these young women. And if that's the best they've got, then all of those women need to do what Ocasio-Cortez is doing and wear it as a badge of honor, because that is truly what it is.